Welcome back to Breakfast. Well, the Beatles practiced it, while celebrities Oprah and Russell Brand have also sung its praises. Transcendental meditation has been lauded as a useful technique for reducing the risk of heart attacks and strokes. A leading researcher in this area is Dr. Robert Schneider, who is visiting from America, and he joins me now. Good morning. Thanks for coming in.
Good morning to you, Melissa.
Explain this to us. What is this transcendental meditation?
Well, medical science has known for a long time about the brain-heart connection, that different kinds of mental stress can speed up the heart, raise blood pressure, increase heart disease. But this is a technique that's originally from an ancient tradition of India, but it's been rediscovered in modern times, and it has been shown by medical research to have a positive effect on the brain-heart connection, to lower blood pressure and have many other health beneficial effects.
I guess one of the first questions, which you said we would have to do a course, but how would you learn this kind of meditation?
This particular technique with the most scientific research is called transcendental meditation, and it's very easy to learn. There's a 7-step course, about an hour and a half a day, over 5 days, and anyone can learn and practice at home for 20 minutes twice a day, close the eyes, and people's minds settle down to a quiet inner state, but they're wide awake. It's a state of restful alertness for mind and body, deep rest and relaxation. That's rejuvenating and balancing for the physiology.
How does it help reduce heart attacks and strokes?
Well, we did this long-term study funded by the U.S. government just looking at that question. We took people with heart disease and followed them for more than 5 years, and it took us 10 years to do the whole study. So one element was lower blood pressure that we saw in the subjects. A second element was lower levels of mental stress, because psychological stress damages the heart. And there are probably changes in other stress-related hormones also that contribute to less damage to the arteries, less damage to the heart. People live longer, about 40% lower risk of death, heart attack, and stroke.
How much of this, though, I guess some people would say, you know, live a healthy life, take some time out, and that would help. So how do you see this meditation as being directly responsible for helping hearts?
Well, that's a good question. And just 2 months ago, the American Heart Association reviewed all the scientific data on different forms of relaxation, meditation, stress management, because everyone says whatever you do may have some effect. But when you look at the hard data, different practices have different effects, different changes in brainwave activity, different changes in hormones. And this particular form of transcendental meditation has unique effects in causing brainwave orderliness or coherence, lowering blood pressure, according to the American Heart Association. And it's the only mind-body intervention that's been shown scientifically to lengthen life and have these positive health benefits.
So you've come out to talk to other medical professionals about this kind of meditation.
That's right. Well, doctors from around New Zealand have invited me, the University of Otago, University of Auckland, and several other places. They want to know, what is this technique? We haven't learned it in medical school, but our patients don't like to take medicines, side effects, costs. They want to be able to heal from within, and what's scientifically validated. So this kind of thing, this work that we've done over the past 30 years, fits right in to the current demand for non-drug methods, for natural methods to prevent disease and promote health.
So what kind of response have you had here?
So far, it's really positive. We had a large group in Auckland last night of the general public. We did a whole day-long seminar. Later on, we're going to the University of Otago. So far, doctors are saying, wow, why didn't I learn about this before? And here's something I can offer to my patients as an option for their care. And individuals are saying, look, here's an alternative for me that I can use, something that not only doesn't have negative side effects, but has positive side benefits, if you will. So far, people are really getting intrigued and excited about this.
All right. Thank you very much. Best of luck with the rest of your trip, Dr. Robert Schneider. Thanks for coming in.
Thank you.
And according to the transcendentalmeditation.org website, but this is New Zealand's sort of, seems to be sort of main website on this, 43,000 New Zealanders use this natural technique. There
That's
you go. 43,000 in order to reduce stress and therefore increase lifespan.